Hello students,
how are you all?
I hope you all are well and you have started preparation for your PT1 exams. And this video is your revision video of both the chapters which are coming in exam, chapter 11 time and motion and chapter 16 water. And your exams will be on campus care application. And your science exam of class 7th is on 7th of August. And your exams will be objective type exam. One question will be there of 1 mark. And 4 options will be there. Out of the 4 options, you have to select the correct option. And 20 questions will be there. 20 mark exam will be there. And timings and all of the exams will be informed from school. You will get the message from school. So, and tomorrow your mock test exams are also there. So, you will get the idea how you have to give the exam through online on campus care application through mock test. You will get the practice of the online exam. Okay, I hope things are clear. So, here we are going to start the revision of chapter 11, time and motion. So, one topic was left in the chapter explanation, pendulum clock. So let's first discuss this and clear it, and then we will discuss all the topics in short. So first is pendulum clock. What is pendulum clock? And you may have seen pendulum clock and you have heard about it. So let's see what is actually pendulum clock. Clocks based on a simple pendulum are also used to measure time. Means the clock based on simple pendulum we used to measure what? Time. Pendulum clock we used to measure time. A pendulum consists of a small mass suspended from a fixed point in such a way that it can swing freely under the influence of gravity. Means in a pendulum clock, as you can see here, this is the small mass and it is suspended freely from this fixed point. It can move freely. So that what it can move freely and can create and can get the oscillation. Means here a pendulum consists of a small mass suspended from a fixed point in such a way that it can swing freely. Means from here this one small mass can swing from here to there freely. So under the influence of gravity, thus the small mass could be a small metallic ball or even a stone. Means that could be a stone or a small metallic ball. It is called a bob. And what it is called? A bob. This is what called bob. Okay. When tied to an inelastic string and made to swing, the bob describes an arc moving from one side to the mean position to the other. How it make an arc? See here. This bob, when swing freely, so it will swing from here and then here again from it will come to go to center and again from here to here. Means this it creates what? An arc. And this is how it makes oscillation also. Means this bob is swing freely from here to there in arc and again from here to there. So moving from one side to the mean position to the other, you can see moving from one side to the mean position, this is mean position and this is the other. Let's see more in detail. The movement of bob to and away from its mean position is called oscillation. What it is called? Oscillation. See here. The movement of bob from here to there, to and away from its mean position is called oscillation. Means this is one oscillation. Okay. this the movement from here you see the movement from here to there means this full this full one movement is what called oscillation. Okay, here the bob movement from here to there, so that is called one oscillation at a time. The time taken to complete one oscillation is called time period, and the time taken to complete one oscillation is called time period. Means here you see the time from here to there, this is what one oscillation, and it is called time period. The pendulum in pendulum clock takes 2 seconds to come back to the mean to the position from where it starts. Means it takes 2 seconds from where it start. Means suppose it start from here, so it will go here and again it will come back to there. So it is what this is the it takes two second time to come back to its original position. Now we will discuss quartz clock. A clock driven by quartz crystal is another time measuring device. Another time measuring device, which one is quartz clock, and it works on the quartz crystal. In this clock, a tiny quartz crystal oscillates freely. In this what? A tiny natural quartz crystal oscillates, due to which the vibrations or it gives us the time. Quartz crystals are capable of vibrating very fast and at a precise rate. Means the quartz crystal having the tendency to vibrate very fast. The fast and precise vibrations help in measuring time accurately, and due to this quartz crystal, due to the vibration of its quartz crystal, it helps us to measure time accurately. Here a small definition: an electric clock in which the current is regulated. Means as you have seen, generally our electric clock, in which what electric clock current will be there, so the current is regulated and accuracy maintained by the regular vibrations of a quartz crystal. Because of the vibrations of the quartz crystal, an electric clock works on regulated and accuracy time period, and it gives us the accurate time because of the vibrations of a quartz crystal. So quartz crystal help us to give the accurate time as we have general electric watches in our homes. We are having now also quartz clock. Here we will discuss in short measurement of time, how we can measure the time in different way. Before the inventions of new electric clocks and watches and digital watches and all, how were before in old times were using the time, were measuring the time. So measurement of time using periodic events. Before that, time was measured? The time was measured using the periodic events. How? Sundial. Suppose if we talk about sundial, a sundial tells time by making use of the fact that objects from shadows at different positions depending on the position of the sun. I have explained you in this chapter video that sundial how works. A gnomon in the gnomon is there in the sundial, which makes a shadow at the with the different position of the sun. Means as the position of the sun will change, the shadow of the gnomon will also change, and this is what different positions of sun and all, it what periodic event. So this sundial was the sundial work on the basis of the periodic event and help us to measure time in the ancient time. Day was also used to measure time. Means the day is also a periodic event. Time taken by the sun to rise, set and rise again, and more time between two consecutive sunrise. So what is day? What is the definition of day? A question can come day. What is day? Means how question can come that the time between two consecutive sunrise or time taken by the sun to rise, set and rise again called what? Day. So you must be knowing what day, what is day, what is sundial, and how a measurement of time using the periodic events like what? Sundial, day. They're working on the concept of the periodic events. Like year. Year is also a periodic event. Duration of time in which the sun appears to make a full circle around the sky. What is the definition of year is here? What? Duration of time in which the sun appears to make a full circle around the sky means the time duration in which the earth rotates complete around the sun, it takes a year. So this is what periodic event means. An earth takes the 1 year time to complete revolution of the sun, to complete rotate around the sun, and it rotate. So here, measurement of time using the sun, like solar day, period from 1 midnight to next, this is also same. Measurement of time using the sun, using the sun, how we can measure time, like what? Solar day. What is the definition of solar day? Period from 1 midnight to next is called solar day. Suppose question can come, period from 1 midnight to next called what? So answer you will be have to selecting what? Solar day. Now measuring time using the star, your spelling mistake is there, please you don't get confused. Measuring time using the stars. Now how using the stars the time was measured? So one definition of sidereal, astronomers use this. Astronomers also measure time by observing Earth's rotation in relation to stars, relating to the distant stars with reference to their apparent position. Means the movement of the Earth's rotation in relation to the other stars is called sidereal. Vernal equinox. As the Earth rotates on its axis, an imaginary point among the stars called the vernal equinox. Means if we see the Earth's rotation in reference to the other star, so this would be called vernal equinox. The time when this happens is called sidereal noon. And at this time when we see the vernal equinox, it is called sidereal noon. Here you can see this is Earth and the imaginary axis. If we see a reference to the other point of in the space, other relating to other star, is called vernal equinox. Then next, instruments for measuring time are, what are the instruments we use for measuring time? You must be knowing what are the instruments given for measuring time. First, sundial, sand clock, water clock, pendulum clock and quartz clock. And all this I have explained you in detail in your previous video, in your chapters video. This is in short, so you can get the revise what is actually given in the instruments for measuring time. So these are the instruments for measuring time. This is what? Sundial. As I told you that gnomon change its position with the changing of the position of sun and gives the time. This is what? This is sand clock. Means the sand is filled in the one jar, and according to the hour, according to time period of this sand clock, means suppose in 1 hour this all sand will go down and again we can make it upright down, so that again we can measure time by seeing the full sand is going down or not. So this is sand clock, this is sundial, this is water clock. It is also worked the same as the sand clock, means the whole water from this upper container to this down container will go down and will measure the time, and every time it will happen same. And this is pendulum clock, means this is the bob, and from one here to there it makes a one oscillation, and the time taken to complete one oscillation is called what? Time period. Please remember. Then which of there is one question, this is the numerical question. It is given in your exercise of chapter 11, time and motion. It was left by mistake, so I am explaining this. And one long question also one left according to the new book. One long question, second long question, it is also numerical one. So it's not important as the exam. Now I will explain it. It will not be asked in the exam. but this please you must be knowing what it is. So here, which of the following two is moving faster? Here spelling mistake, please don't get confused. Which of the following two is moving faster? A car going over a distance of 400 km in 5 hours, and B1, a train covering a distance of 500 km in 6 hours. Means A1 is faster or B1 is faster? We have to find. Here is what condition? A car is covering a distance of 400 km in 5 hours, and here train is covering a distance of 500 km in 6 hours. So how we will get that which one is faster? So let's solve it. So solution, first one we are solving given. Distance equal to what? 400 km. Here distance is given 400 km and time t. Here d is showing distance. D denotes distance and t denotes time. And t here 5 hours. So we know the formula of speed. We have to find what speed. Because of speed only we can tell that which one is faster speed. So you must be knowing speed equal to distance upon time. So here we will put the values of distance upon time. Distance is what? 400 km. Time is 5 hours. When you will divide 400 by 5, you will get what? 80. So S equal to, means speed equal to 80 km per hour. So first car's speed is what? 80 km per hour. Now let's solve second part B1. So when we will solve second part B1, in the B1 distance is given D equals to 500 km. You can see distance is 500 km and time is 6 hours. So here distance 500 km and time 6 hours. So according to the speed formula, distance upon time, we will put the value S equal to distance upon time. So distance value 500 km, time value 6 hours. And when you will divide 500 by 6, you will get 83.33 km per hour. Means in a, we can say what? 83.33. So in round off we can say 83. 83 km per hour. And the here you can see car's speed is 80 km per hour, and in second train speed is 83.33 km per hour. So I hope you have understood now. So whose speed is greater here? Train's speed is greater. So we can say therefore here train's speed is greater than car's speed. So the train will be moving faster. So here it was asked which of the following two is moving faster. So by finding the value of speed of both these parts, and we come to know that the train speed is greater, so the train will be moving faster. Okay, clear? Now we will discuss some summary points of this chapter. As you know, first point, time is the duration between two events and it is continuous. Time is what? The time period between two events, or duration between two events, and time is a continuous process. Earlier periodic events were used to measure time. Question can come, how on what based the earlier the time was measured? Basis on what? So we can say on basis of periodic events like sundial, like based on day, solar day and all. A periodic event is one which occurs at regular interval of time. What is the periodic event definition? Definition: periodic event is one which occurs at regular interval of time. Like example, day, night, seasons. This is what all periodic event which comes and which occurs at regular interval of time. Fourth point, water clocks, sand clocks, sundials and candles were used to measure time earlier. What are the instrument or what are the clocks? Which type of clocks were used to measure earlier? Water clocks, sand clocks, sundials and candles. Fifth point, the time period of pendulum clock is 2 seconds. You must be knowing what is the time period of pendulum clock is 2 seconds. Sixth point, the time period of a pendulum depends only on the length of the pendulum. Means time period of a pendulum depends on the length of the pendulum. Okay, if length of the pendulum will change, maybe the time period also can change. Distance covered per unit time is called speed. And what is the definition of speed? Means distance. If speed formula, you know what is the speed formula? Distance upon time, means distance over time. So here distance covered per unit of time means the total distance covered as per unit of time, we may define it is as speed. At the point, the SI unit to measure time is meter per second. You must be knowing what is the SI unit of speed is meter per second. Ninth point, uniform motion. What is uniform motion? Uniform motion is the one in which a moving body covers equal distance in equal interval of time. Means the motion which covers every time equal distance and equal time interval we call as uniform motion. Example what? Suppose a car travels in first hour 5 km, in second hour again 5 km, in third hour again 5 km. Means in every hour distance is same, 5 km, 5 km, 5 km. So here we can say the car is in uniform motion. If we talk about non-uniform motion, it is the one in which a body moves with changing speeds. Means here with the different changing of time, the speed can be changed or covers unequal distance in equal time interval. Means example what? Suppose in first hour a car travels 5 km. In next hour the car travels 7 km. In again next hour it travels 3 km. Means with the different hours the speed is changing. In first hour 5 km, second hour 7 km, third hour 3 km. Means distance is changing but time interval is same. So here means speed will also change with the with the changing of distance. So here we will say the non-uniform motion is what? It is the one with in which a body moves with changing speeds. If the speed is same in every hour, it will be uniform motion. And if speed is changing again and again, then it will be of non-uniform motion. 11th point, the distance time graph for a uniform motion is a straight line. Always remember, if we represent the distance and time on the graph of uniform motion, so it will be of always of a straight line. And the graph for non-uniform motion is non-linear. It can be of curve, it can be of any type. But always uniform motion graph line will be a straight line and non-uniform motion will be non-linear. Non-linear means not in a line. Okay, I can show you here. You see, this first graph is of uniform motion. Here time is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, suppose it is given in second, and here it is given in minute meters. So first second 100 meter, second minute 200 meter, third minute 300 meter. Means the distance, how much it is taking here? First second 100, second in first to second for 1 second, then in second 2 second. So there is distance what? 100 meter. Means here 100 meter, then it is more change 100 meter, then again 100 meter. Means distance interval is what? Here distance gap is 100 meter, and here the time gap is 1 second. So here you can see the uniform motion, the graph is a straight line. So it is showing what? Straight line in uniform motion. Okay, here if we talk about non-uniform motion, here timing is same, means time interval is 1 second, 1 second, 2 second, 3 second, 4 second and all. But here if we see about it, here in 1 second how much it has taken? 10 meter. In second 1 second it has taken 15 meter. Then in third second 15, more than 15, it can be 17 and all. Then in 4th second it is 20 meter. Means the gap between distance is not same. So here the line will not be straight. It can be curve, it can be zigzag, it is of any type. So this is the mean to say, in uniform motion straight line will be there, and in non-uniform motion non-linear line. And more it can clear, see, this is the uniform motion graph. And in the case of non-uniform motion, the graph could be like this, of any type it could be in the case of non-uniform motion. Okay, I hope it is clear to you, and I have already explained in detail also. So second, 12th point, the idea of speed enable us to distinguish between slow and fast object. Means if speed idea will be there, then only we can say who is slow and who is fast. who is a slower speed and who is having faster speed. The greater the speed, the steeper is the distance time graph. Means if greater will be the greater speed, more greater the speed will be there, the more steeper. Steeper means the more steepness, means the more changes will be in the distance time graph, means the more straight line will be there. Now next we will discuss about chapter 16, water. So here we must be knowing what are the sources of water. What are the sources of water? Oceans and seas, rain and snow, rivers, lakes and ponds, wells and springs. Through these we get the water on earth. So these are the sources of water. States of water. You know the water is present in three states. Let's discuss. All of us are familiar with the three states of water. First, water, the liquid state. Water is in the liquid state. This is the most abundantly used state of water and is found in water bodies like seas and rivers, etc. The liquid state in water present in seas, rivers, lakes, ponds, etc. Second state of water is ice, the frozen solid state. In nature, frozen water in the form of ice and snow is found on mountains, peaks, glaciers, etc. At these places, the water is found in the form of ice, means solid state. Third, water vapor, the gaseous state. Water vapor is which state? Gaseous state. And this is present as a component of air, means the water vapors can mix in the air, means we can say that the water vapor can be present in the air, so we can say it is present as a component of air. Next point, topic is depletion of water table. Depletion means what? The level of water table when getting down, means the depletion of water level means the low the level of water table when gets low, we call as depletion of water table. So why it happens, means why water table is getting down, why it gets depleted, means decreasing of water table. Why? Because of the these reasons. Urbanization, means increasing industries, increasing construction work, increasing buildings and all. Due to this, what water required and lot of quantity it requires. So due to this also water table getting down, urbanization, then increase in agriculture. As the population increasing, agriculture also gets increased. So due to this also water table getting down. Deforestation means cutting of forest, cutting of trees and all, and it all creates the water table decrease, and due to all these reasons that water table getting low, means depletion. Then here, what are the factors of scarcity of water in India, means why scarcity of water is there in India? What are the factors responsible for scarcity of water? Don't get confused due to the spelling mistake. Okay, so here first, geographical parameters, means geographical parameter is the factor for responsible of water scarcity of water. Over exploitation of resources. In over exploitation of resources means for population explosion, due to the increasing of the population, resources also gets using more and more. Pollution is there, agriculture. So these are the factors which causes the scarcity of water in India. Third is conservation of water. What are the different process through which we can conserve water? So here, rainwater harvesting, means we can collect rainwater at our homes through a tank, and then we can use this water for different purpose. So here, through this we can save water. Efficient distribution of water, means proper distribution of water, through the proper distribution of water we can save water. Prevention of wastage, prevention of wastage means we can save water to not get waste, to not get polluted. Through these different process we can conserve water. You can see this is the picture of rainwater harvesting. This is how we can save rainwater at our homes, and through these pipes and through the different tanks and all, we can make it down to the water level so that it helps to increase the water table. So let's discuss the important terms of this chapter. First, dam. What is dam? A barrier constructed to hold water, to hold back water and raise its level. Means it is a dam is a barrier it is the a barrier between two parts, so that it can hold water at that place and can increase the water level, forming a reservoir for preventing flooding, and it helps to prevent flood. If water will store at one place, will be hold back at one place, so it will not be able to move flow at further, so it can help in preventing flooding. And you can see this is what dam. This part helps to water to stay, to make it hold back here, and it increase the water table at here, at this place. Second, desalination. What is desalination? Process of removal of salt from sea water. As you know, the salt is present in seawater. Seawater is saline. So the process of removal of salt from seawater is called desalination process. It is important you must be knowing what is desalination. The questions could be asked like this: the process of removal of salt from seawater. So you must be knowing it is what? Desalination. Then groundwater. What is groundwater? Water held underground in the soil or in pores and crevices of rocks. Means it is explained already in very detail. Means water, the under the ground, water is present in between the rocks, in between the layers of soil and all. So that water we called as groundwater. Then next is what? Precipitation. What is precipitation? Rain, snow, sleet or hail that falls or condenses on the ground. Means this is what precipitation. You see, the rain water, snow and all, it from the clouds, it gets down on the earth, on the surface of the earth or soil. So this is called precipitation. Water table, the level below which the ground is saturated with water. Means under the ground, the level of the water under the ground which is saturated with water, means filled with water, the level which is under the ground filled with water, so that level is called water table. Infiltration, process by which rainwater seeps into the ground through the soil and gets collected as groundwater, thereby raising the water table. Infiltration means what? See here, infiltration means the rainwater or the water from the ground, it seeps, means it absorbs through the soil and collect as the under the soil. So that water, that process is called, means the absorbing of water from the surface of the soil and through the small pores and all. So this process is called infiltration. Okay, process by which when rainwater falls on the surface, it is absorbed through the soil and gets collected as groundwater, and it increases the water table, and this process is called infiltration. Here you more, that picture will clear you more that this is the level under the ground, the level of the water is what? Water table. And the water stored under the surface, under the ground, that is what called groundwater. And the water present on the surface is called surface water. Here, one more, aquifers and springs. What is aquifer and springs? An underground layer of permeable rock, sand, sediment or soil that collects, holds and transmits water to wells or springs. Aquifer means what? The underground layer, in this layer, the water present in between the rocks, sand and sediments or soil, which holds the water and transmit this water to wells and springs. So this part is called aquifer. Here you see, this is what aquifer here. Okay, so this water is collected, it is held there, and this water is present between this soil, between the rocks and all. And then this water can transmit through the wells and all. So you can see here artesian well. See here, the water, suppose it is stored here, it is held back here in between the bedrock. These are the rocks. The water is present in between the rock. Okay. So this water when transmit through for the well, so this part is called aquifer. Okay. This is aquifer. Most commonly known as groundwater, it is more known as groundwater and may create large underground reservoir of varying size, and it is the reservoir of water under the ground in a large form of reservoir. means it is the reserving of water under the ground and help to transmit the water in the wells and spring. So this is all the topics we have discussed. In short, we have revised so that you can again revise all these topics for the exam. I hope things are clear, and please be ready for the exam and give your exams well. All the best. Thank you, children.